So let's pretend I'm teaching guitar and I've got office hours on this robot over here. This is Double Robotics robot. And I'll put a little guitar on here so it feels more like it's got a guitar. And I'm waiting for my student Laura to show up for her 30-minute lesson. And I've got these scheduled all through the day. So I'm doing one at a time this way. So Laura's going to pop on here and become the robot here in a second. Hi, Laura.
Hi, how's it going?
Good. You're welcome. Are you ready for your first guitar lesson?
I'm a little nervous.
Oh, we're going to keep this so simple, okay? You have to know that you're a really cool-looking robot right now, and you're holding a really cool Gibson guitar. But we're both playing Taylors. This is a 12-string Taylor, and you've got your hubby's home Taylor. He's got a home Taylor. Oh, wow.
Yeah, he has a travel Taylor, and then this is the one that stays home. It's a concert piano or a concert Taylor. He didn't like the pickup and the sound system as well as the other one he bought,
Nice. You're a good wife to let him have all these guitars. So this first lesson, we're going to do a song called Horse With No Name. And I start with that one because it's one of the easiest songs I can start you with. So here's how it's going to work. This is the first fret, second fret, third fret, fourth fret. And you'll forgive me. I'm treating you like you're in fifth grade so I can practice how I would talk to a kid. First, second, third, fourth. And now I'm going to count the strings from the bottom up. Some people count from the top down. I count from the bottom up. So it's one, two, three, four, five, six, right? So this first chord we're going to play is going to have your second finger, this finger here, on the fifth string in the second fret. Okay? And you might just put that on the screen so I can kind of see how you're laying that down there. Awesome. Okay, now your third finger is going to go on the fourth string in the second fret. And when you do, in the second fret, one, two, three, four, there you go, right there. Now slide back a little bit so you're not crowding the fret line. That way we don't get a buzz. Good. Now that is an E minor. You're playing an E minor right now. So I want you to strum that. Let me hear it. Nice. We got the same sound. That's cool. So I want you to go like this. You're going to tap your foot and we're going to go up, down, up, down. Nothing complicated. Listen to me for just a moment. Tapping your foot on the downstroke, 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 downstroke. So give me that, see what that sounds like. One.
Do I need a pick?
I'm gonna teach you, you can get a pick, but let me teach you a trick, okay? If you do this, like you're making a duck with your hand, like whack, 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 whack. What happens is your fingernails on this side are on this side and your thumbnails on this side. If you hold that and go like this, you've got a built-in pick. So try that, just. Actually, that's not too bad for the first time you've done it. You're kidding around. You've done this before, haven't you? Now, let me show you.
I know guitar. So, I just live with guitar.
So that little duck bill thing that we're doing there, right, for a pick, I want to show you what that can sound like. So I'm going to do it like a little faster, like I'm doing the song. So. When you get better at that, your fingers kind of float and then you can just slap that thing without a pick. And it's nice to have that because there's times when you're somewhere, someone says, hey, pull out your guitar, and you don't have a pick and you're trying to make one out of something. And everyone thinks that you can use a quarter, you'll break your strings, you know, but whatever. So this is a little solution. So now we're going to go back to that E minor again. And thanks for holding it. Let me hear it again. I want to make sure it's clean with no buzzes.
One's longer than the other.
Why don't you use the side of your thumb? It'll be softer, but we can do that. The side of your thumb.
Okay.
Now, I want you to notice something. Most students aren't as good as you are right now because you're holding your fingers down hard enough to not get a mute or a buzz. And congratulations, most people really have a hard time with that. Although it's probably hurting right now, isn't it? A little bit.
Yes.
So I gotta tell you, you know, a week from now or 2 weeks from now, when you start to get calluses, it won't hurt anymore. In fact, I kind of want you to play a guitar with a high action so that process is faster. You know, some of the Gibsons have such nice low action that when someone hands you another guitar that maybe it's a 12 string, it hurts. I like the pain to be over quick. That's just my philosophy. So now here's what you're gonna do. There's only two chords in this whole song. So in the second chord, it goes like this. Your second finger goes up one string. And your third finger goes down one string. I call it doing the splits. Now play that. Yay, yay. Now watch me for a second, okay? I'm gonna go back to that E minor, right? The E minor. Now that means your second finger goes down one and your third finger goes up one. That's it. You've got the whole song already. That's all there's going to be. So we're going to go, and watch me for a minute. Let's go really slow with that. Let's start with that E minor and go, we're going to go down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Then the splits. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. And it's okay. No rules, no audience. Let's just do this. The splits. And you're doing fine. You're doing fine. We're not on stage. Yeah, you're good. You're good. You're good. Nice. Now go back to that first position. Now, if this was a regular lesson and you were my real student, I would give you only that, and you would do that until our next lesson. And my challenge to you would be to make it smooth. And I would give you how the count, like 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. There's four of those. Then change 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. And keep thinking of the splits. Back to first position. Back to second position.
I'm afraid I can't do that yet.
Okay, thank you, Alexa. So I'm gonna have you do that with me. So the timing is always gonna be weird and laggy, but we can try it. I'm gonna have you start strumming. I'm gonna try to play with you. Okay.
All right. So 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, yeah, that was pretty good. Better kick your third finger down one. There you go. That's the splits. Back to the first position. You're doing so good. Oh my gosh. How many times have you played this song? How many times did you play guitar?
I've never played guitar.
Yay! Okay, now I'm gonna end the lesson, but I'm gonna give you a little preview here. So this is what you'll be doing.
Okay.
And if you can do this by the time I see you again, you'll get extra credit, but it's gonna go. First part of the journey. That's the splits. I was E minoring in all the splits. There was E minor in grass and rocks and splits. Okay, and the other assignment I have is I want you to listen to that song on Spotify, on the radio, wherever you listen to it. Because I think you're going to hear and you're going to say, oh my gosh, I'm actually playing that song. It's really E minor. It's really those chords. And that'll make you feel a little more legit, okay? So first, you're going to practice, right? And we're going to keep doing that until you don't even have to think about the splits. You just do them and come back and do them and come back. And then your timing. I want to make sure you're tapping your foot. So we're keeping even time on that. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. And the next time I see you, I can't wait to see how much improvement you've made.
This is why I hold a mic. It's easier. Okay.
You might actually learn this song. Woo! Surprise your hubby. Thanks for doing this with me. I really appreciate this. You rocked
it. My daughter wants a good bass lesson, so I'm thinking I need a robot.
There you go. Yeah.
Okay.
We'll see you.
All right. Thank you.
Bye bye.
Bye.
First of all, it's good to have friends that are game to try new things. That's one of my favorite friends in the whole world. It's Laura Steinbrink. And if you're following her on Twitter, it's Steinbrink, Steinbrink, Laura, Laura. Trust me, she's worth it. She pumps out so much good stuff all the time that you almost can't keep up with it. But she's a real teacher, works with real kids, and it just knows our issues. So anyway, give her a follow, and thanks for watching this. It's just all about the possibilities, right? Looking for things. And by the way, this is not cheap, but a used one, I've seen them all the way down to $250, all the way, you know, somewhere in the mid-range. I've seen them $500. So you don't have to buy a brand new one or do a GoFundMe campaign if you had one of these in your school. and kids could check into it, and teachers had office hours, and maybe I use it in the morning from 8 to 10, and the band teacher uses it from 10 or 10:15 to, you know, 12:15 or just after lunch or whatever. PE teacher, who knows what. This one-on-one instruction, just another model, something to look at. Anyway, see you next time.